Good morning, everyone. In the previous session of Global HRD, I was explaining about the views regarding HRD given by various authors. So there are around 10 to 12 authors who have actually described HRD from their own point of view. What are the basic things that they have focused while explaining the concept of HRD? Okay. In this session, I'm going to explain the retrospect of HRD. So first of all, what is retrospect? Retrospect simply means that a review of the past. So we are going to review the past of the HRD. Past means how this concept was coined, what are the various concepts which led to the creation of the concept of HRD. So that is the retrospect of HRD. So in this session, I am going to explain how this concept of HRD was developed, how it was coined, what are the various concepts which are behind the creation of the concept of HRD. And then I'm going to explain the HRD in the Indian concept, Indian context, that is retrospect of HRD in Indian context. Okay. So first of all, the term HRD was coined by Leonard Nadler and Professor Emeritus. And they were working in George Washington University. So they were given the credit for coining the term for the first time, the term that is HRD. So Leonard Nadler wrote a book that is called Developing Human Resource. In that book, he has mentioned the term for the very first time. And after mentioning the term in that book, various other things were related to the concept of HRD, like training, development, and education. So according to him, HRD is very essential for the organization as well as for the employees. Now, what are the three elements should become part of the HRD aspect? That is training, development, and education. Simple training regarding doing a job is not sufficient until and unless an employee learns to develop his skills, his potentials, his qualities and capabilities. So development is also very important, overall development of all the employees. And at the same time, education. Imparting proper knowledge to the employees, educating them, developing their level of knowledge, all these things has become an important part of HRD. So after when the term was coined, these three elements were put together as an essential part of HRD. So like I already said, that retrospect means reviewing the past of the HRD. Sorry, reviewing the past of any related particular matter. So here we are going to review the past of HRD, how this HRD concept was developed, how this term was coined. So like I have already said that this term was coined by Leonard Nadler and Professor Emeritus. So these were the two people who first coined the term HRD. And after that, various number of authors have given their opinion regarding HRD. Like McLagan, Patricia McLagan also mentioned HRD as an important aspect for every organization. And she also mentioned that for economic development of a country, HRD becomes very essential. So this was the opinion. This was the opinion of Patricia McLagan regarding the concept of HRD. In 1989, organizations started giving importance to HRD because it was actually mentioned that it is very essential for the economic development of the country, and in order for an organization to grow and develop, proper development of human resource became very necessary. So during that time only, the system concept of HRD was developed. How HRD programs need to be created, what are the various systems need to be the essential part of HRD. So during that year, since that year, HRD was given proper, like I said, proper place in every organization, and they considered this term very important for both both for the benefits of the organization as well as for the benefit of the employee. So 1989 was the year from which HRD was given proper importance in the companies, in various companies and organizations. Okay. There are various trends through which from which the concept of HRD has actually developed. So I am going to explain all the various concepts which led to the creation of the concept of HRD. So the first concept in the field of human resource was the commodity concept. So as you all already know that human resource were treated just like commodity by the various organization, and this is way back, many years back, around 50 years, 100 years back, human resource were treated simply like commodity. They were not given proper importance in the organization. Their welfare, their security was not even a question for the organization. So like any other commodity, they were treated, human resource were treated like that only, okay? The amount of wages paid to the workers were very low. Like I said, proper measures regarding the security of the workers and employees were not taken very seriously. Even government of many countries didn't even give proper importance to human resource, their development and their welfare. So because of these kind of things, human resource were treated like other commodities, okay? And then another concept developed, the factor of production concept. Now in this, what happened, labor, the workers were treated like any other factor of production, like machinery, material and all that. And in this situation also, even if workers gave workers were given little bit of more wages, but the condition was still the same. They were not given proper welfare measures. Welfare measures were not created for them. There was no kind of security for the workers. Their rights were, they didn't have any kind of rights. They were simply treated like machineries. So they were exploited. Even if with little wages, they had to work for many hours. So they were exploited by the big organizations. They were not treated properly. So this was the concept of production. This was the factor of production concept, okay? After the factor of production concept, another concept evolved, that is the goodwill concept. Now, when this concept began, welfare measures were taken by many organizations. Now, welfare measures like the safety and different kinds of benefits were provided to the employees so that it can boost the morale. It can motivate the employees so that they would like to perform even better for attaining more and more benefits. So we can say that from the goodwill concept, it actually helped the organization to understand the importance of the human resource. So we can actually say that this led to the creation of the concept of HRD. This, we can say that this was the beginning of the creation of the concept of HRD. So even if many authors say that HRD existed from the beginning of the organization, but still the human resource were not given that prior importance which they always deserved. But with the goodwill concept, when organizations started understanding the use of the human resource, what kind of benefits this human resource provide to the organization, and in return they started giving different kinds of benefits to the employees, to the workers, in order to feel that the organization also cares for them, the organization is concerned for them. So this developed a sense of belongingness in the employees, in the human resource, okay? And after goodwill concept, paternalistic concept was developed. So basically, paternalistic concept means having some kind of protective attitude towards the employees and workers, means having a fatherly figure in the organization. Like management must show some kind of a fatherly figure to the organization, where employees would feel protected, that their rights, their benefits, all are protected by the management, because the management considered us as a part of a family. So this protective attitude was not limited to benefits and all that. It also focused on satisfying the human resource in various terms, like providing job satisfaction, providing proper working environment, providing or handling the problems of the workers and employees, grievance handling, all those things came into existence in the paternalistic concept. So here we can see that slowly, when organizations started understanding the value of the human resource, they started improving the benefits which they are supposed to provide to the human resource. They started adding up more and more benefits, giving them more priority. So this was the initial beginning of the HRD concept. So in paternalistic concept, management provided various types of facilities. Management considered the opinion of the employees. They considered like I said, various types of things that provide satisfaction to the employees from when they work in an organization. So these are the various aspects in paternalistic concept. The next one is humanitarian concept. Okay. So the humanitarian concept actually made it very clear that the organization needs to take care of the workers and the employees, because the production, the productivity of an organization, the quality of their performance, how successful they are, everything actually depends upon the workforce of the organization, what kind of people are appointed in the organization, and to what extent they are satisfied within the organization. That actually makes an organization successful. So under the humanitarian concept, organizations and companies started taking care of their they started providing various benefits, facilities, and they have also started creating a good and healthy working environment where the problems and issues can be easily solved. They also started giving counseling sessions to the employees. So this was the concept which actually made the organization realize that without having satisfied employees, the organization cannot become successful. They cannot simply give the employees more and more amount of work. Even if they pay them higher, there are other things that needs to be satisfied. So the aspirations of the employees are considered. They were given proper opportunities for growth and development. So all these things were an important part of humanitarian concept. And the last one is the emerging concept of HRD. So after the development of the various concepts, these concept of HRD came into existence, where employees were accepted as partners in the progress of the organization. So organization without good and efficient workforce cannot handle any of its other factors of production. So for the management of the organization, for efficient utilization of other factors of production, employees should be treated as partners because they have equal contribution in the success of the organization. So each and every aspect of an employee must be considered. Training, development, counseling, performance appraisal, coaching, all those things became an integral part for every organization. So according to various authors and various philosophers and all, they actually mentioned that without having a successful, efficient and satisfied group of people, organization cannot reach to their highest point. So in the present scenario also, where competition is very high, many new businesses have started, many organizations entering into same kind of business. So in this competitive environment, an efficient group of workforce is extremely essential for every organization. So obviously, each and every aspect of HRD has become very important, whether it is performance appraisal or performance coaching. So these all elements became an integral part of the organization, and then HRD concept was given that kind of importance which it always actually deserved, because human resource needs to be treated in a proper way, or else the productivity of the entire organization would be very low. So from that point of view, after going through all the concepts, still humanitarian concept, the next one was the emerging concept of HRD. So from this concept, HRD got prior importance, prior place in every organization, where each and every aspect of an employee is considered. They were given proper development sessions, training sessions, counseling sessions. So that made HRD an integral part of all the organization. Okay, so these are the various concepts which led to the creation of the HRD concept. Okay, now I'm going to explain what is the retrospect of HRD in India, how it initially started, how it was developed, and what are those companies who accepted HRD in the initial stages. So all these things will come under this aspect. Okay. So like in any other country, in India also, human resource were not given that kind of importance. We didn't have strong rules and regulations protecting the rights of the workers and the employees. We didn't have much of the basic foundation which is required to give importance, to give what human resource actually deserve. So that was the main problem in India also. But after the introduction of HRD, after growing, like after LPG, when industrialization started growing, when various foreign companies entered into the Indian market for the business, they brought their policies regarding human resource. They brought their different standards of treating their human resource who is working in the organization. So that led many of the Indian companies to accept HRD, to implement HRD, and also provide various kinds of benefits to satisfy the employees, make them feel that the organization is also considers the importance of the employees. So because of various foreign organization, they brought a different kind of working culture. So that led many Indian companies to accept human resource development. So HRD approach encompasses employees as a whole. So first of all, HRD does not mean that we are going to train the employees for the job for which he or she is appointed. HRD basically involves employee as a whole. How an employee can be developed as a whole. We are not just focused on developing few aspects of an employee. We want to train the employee so that the person will be eligible enough to do the work properly, efficiently. We want to improve the knowledge, skills, potentials, capabilities of the employee so that the person would be eligible for future higher position. Clear? So these are the various things which became part of HRD, overall development of an employee. So that was very important. And in that overall development, there are many factors which are needed to be considered. See, we cannot keep on just training the employees, providing them different kinds of development program, making them go through different kinds of educational programs and all that. At the same time, we need to consider various other factors. We need to consider their psychological factor, what kind of psychology our employees have, whether they're happy with those kinds of development, whether even they are ready for those kind of programs and all. So those things needed to be considered. Okay. So these various factors actually included job satisfaction, healthy working environment, a proper redressal of grievances, counseling sessions, and many more. So each and every factor which is related to human resource comes under human resource development. So in order to develop a person properly, we need to make the person satisfied. We need to fulfill the aspirations of the candidates, of the employees. We need to provide them various opportunities through which they can grow, they can develop, and they can achieve their dreams. So all those things, career planning, career development, succession planning, all those things became an integral part of human resource development. So this concept was actually accepted by many organizations. So another point mentioned here is that HRD is not an isolated overview. We cannot isolate HRD. Like I said, we are not only focusing on training the employees, developing the employees, or educating the employees. At the same point of time, we are also considering the various factors which influence the workforce, either positively or negatively. We need to eradicate all the factors which demotivates the employees, which discourages the employees, which have a negative impact on the employees. So we need to eradicate all those things. We need to introduce all those things which are going to motivate the employees, which are going to satisfy the employees, and various other things. So it cannot work in an isolated manner. It had to be collaborated with various other things. We see, organization depends upon HRD, but at the same time, we have to focus on other elements. So we have to see how our HRD program is well coordinated with the other functions of HRD. So our employees will be happy and satisfied. At the same time, the organization would perform better and better. So we cannot isolate HRD. We need to include HRD so that it can be properly coordinated with every other function of the organization. Okay. So the first point which is mentioned here is that HRD in LIC. So like I said, when foreign companies entered into the Indian market, they brought their culture, they brought higher standard of working, they brought how well, they brought different kinds of HR policies and strategies. So during that time, many organizations, Indian organizations, started evaluating their corporate culture and strategies and all that. So initially, those organizations which went through some kind of changes where LIC and SBI and Bank of Baroda, there were very many other banks and other institutions also, which started thinking about making some changes in the HR policies, in not only in HR matter, but in overall matter. So from 1981 to 1983, LIC conducted a proper kind of analysis. So from 1981 to 83, LIC conducted a proper analysis and research on the work system of entire LIC. So in that system, they analyzed about the production, marketing, training, development, each and every aspect of the LIC. So after going through proper analysis and research, they came to a conclusion that certain changes are required in the organization. Certain changes required in the working system of the organization, the things which are related to human resource. So this was the initial beginning, we can say, introduction of HRD in LIC. So after this analysis, LIC came to a conclusion that they need to make various changes, whether it is in marketing, whether it is in production, whether it is in training. But they have focused on a overall basis on HRD, that our human resource needed to be treated better. They are supposed to get better benefits and all that. So this was the beginning of HRD in LIC. So LIC and other many organizations started incorporating HRD in their organizations. Okay. In 1988, another step was taken, was a work planning review. So in this system, what happened? This system was not part of the appraisal system, but this was actually related to planning of the work by the employees, by the workers. So what actually happened in this work planning review? Employees and workers used to plan their work keeping in mind that how the work can be done in an efficient and effective manner. So they are going to plan it for around 1 year, that these are the things, these are the tasks and steps need to be followed in order to do the task, do the job in a proper and a better way. So they need to properly work out what they are supposed to do, represent it to the supervisors, and then execute it. And after that, then after execution of the plan, we can find out what are the major problems in the work planning, or what kind of changes are required to be done in the work planning review. So it is not that big, but it still asked the employees to give their contribution in the way they are working. So they started giving their opinion, they started giving their point of view. They also thought that which type of what type of activities and what type of job or work is going to make the task more effective and more efficient. So the, first of all, they have to plan it, what they are supposed to do in order to achieve their target, then execute it. And if it is successful, if they can repeat it again and again, and if it is not that successful, they can review the planning, what they have done, make necessary changes, and then again use it. Okay. And the last point in the retrospective of HRD is post 1991. So what actually happened after 1991? The LPG, liberalization, privatization, and globalization. So which in that time period, in after 1991, the Indian market was open for foreign investment. Foreign companies were allowed to enter into Indian market, do their business, give employment to many unemployed Indian youth. And this was the beginning of a new kind of work environment, new kind of market, new kind of work culture, where foreign companies entered into Indian market. The competition level increased. So because of these kind of things, the focus on HRD became more important. Like I said, when foreign companies entered into Indian market, they brought their work culture, higher work culture, higher standards, higher expectation. They had a different kind of professionalism in their operations. So they brought all those things to the Indian market. Now, Indian organization, they have to better themselves, they have to improve themselves, or else the foreign organization would become more powerful in the Indian market. So this led to the increase in competition. So because of this competition, every Indian organization made necessary changes to compete with the foreign standards, whether it is related to production, whether it is related to marketing, or whether it is related to human resource. So they started applying various approaches of HRD in the organization so that they can retain their efficient and talented employees within the organization. Okay, so LPG created a new kind of business in the in Indian market. Even if many organizations which were very old, they had to make necessary changes in order to survive in the market, in order to survive in the competitive scenario where many organizations with better technology, with better materials, with better machinery entered into the Indian market. So they appointed Indian people, they tried to develop and train them. So this was the basic introduction of HRD in the Indian market, in the Indian in the Indian context. So after LPG post 1991, organizations started giving importance to the human resource. Various new rules and regulations were also created to protect the rights of the workers and the employees. Still now, many kind of changes are introduced in the operations in the corporate sectors in order to benefit the employees. Now at present, we all can see that we all are going through a pandemic. And in this situation also, many organizations has provided facility to work at home. So this is also some kind of, it is also part of human resource development. They're protecting their employees, they're following the rules and regulations of the government. They're not putting the lives of their employees in danger. So these are the things. And with time, these things, this steps for the betterment of the employees are going to increase. So the future prospect means HRD is already introduced in India. It has a future prospect means how it is going to be improved, how it can be improved in a better way in future. That is also I'm going to teach you in my next session. So next, in the next session, see, in this session I have mentioned how HRD started, but HRD didn't start with any kind of limitations or problems. It had many problems. It had many limitations. Many organizations who were working from many years in with one working culture, suddenly they have to make changes. So those kind of changes were not accepted by many organizations. So they actually faced many difficulties for implementing, for introducing HRD. So in my next session, first of all, I am going to explain what are the difficulties which Indian organization, Indian companies faced while implementing and introducing HRD. And then I'm going to explain the future prospects of HRD, how, what kind of development it can bring in future in Indian context, in global context, and overall what kind of benefits organization can actually achieve in future. So these two topics I will be discussing in my next session. And I think next session is going to be the last session of the first unit. So after completion of the first unit, I'm going to do a revision through a Google Meet regarding the entire unit, what kinds of doubts you all have. Yeah, we will have a doubt clearance session. And then I will do two case studies regarding the first unit. And after that, we will move on to the second unit. So that's it for today. Retrospect of HRD in global and Indian context. In this session, I'm going to explain the limitations which organization faced while implementing HRD and the prospects of HRD. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you.